New opportunities were calling in 1847. The story of the first woolen mill in Salem begins. The clean running water was a draw for such a large operation. Children of that day would swim downstream from the woolen mills. One child was always a lookout, warning others to get out when they saw a dye coming their way. No one wanted to go home to their mothers the color of that day's dye bath. Harsh chemicals and dyes were used, then dumped back into the once clean stream. It is important to preserve history and know history in its entirety. The good and the ugly, so we can make better decisions as we move forward. The Pendleton Woolen Mills have an EcoWise wool line that meets the C2C protocol, otherwise known as cradle to cradle. They meet and try to exceed current environmental laws. This mill was started in part by Fanny K. Bishop, Thomas K.'s daughter and wife of C.P. Bishop of the Salem Thomas K. Woolen Mill.
Howdy. Welcome to the Willamette Heritage Center at the Mill. My name is Peter Booth. I am the Executive Director. What we like to say here is that we're telling our local history like it's never been told before. That includes our permanent exhibits, which are wonderful, talking about the mill and the historic homes, but we're changing our exhibits constantly. We just finished our beer exhibit called History on Tap, and it's a history of brewing in the Willamette Valley, and we're about to open an exhibit called Art and Tradition of Kimono. And this is a neat collection of a woman that migrated to Portland in 1913, was brought here as a bride, and she continued to make kimonos when she got here.
The exhibit of kimonos, created during the 20th century, is an example of the rich variety that the Willamette Heritage Center at the Mill brings through its doors and opens to our community. I know, we've been trying to tell you this is not just a museum. But really, this is not just a museum. They have a great cafe and unique shops. And if you think the sign Max Marble's bookbinding says it all, then you definitely need to stop by and have a chat with Max. Quiet footpaths and bridges bring you into the past. Slow down, enjoy the history and the wildlife.